what that is.
This? Yeah, this is a little, I guess, model of a Pioneer pump. The real thing can be massive, but they're all towable, so you'd hook them behind a truck and they're, you know, they'll get towed in and out of here all day long. You'll see a bunch of them. Yeah, pumps are, I don't think anybody wakes up and says, oh, I'm gonna be in the pump industry, you know, when I get older, but it's just something that kind of finds you. I'm Tom Henderson, president and founder of Capital Pump and Equipment. We're a full service pump distribution company and rental company. We have two different divisions and under one umbrella. We work on major infrastructure projects. A lot of our customers are cities, municipalities, agricultural customers, mines, aggregate plants. You know, we do a lot of dewatering and any type of moving of liquid that somebody may need. There's a lot of water to move, I guess. And we do it in manufacturing plants and mines. It's all over the map.
This is Arizona Business Today. We share stories of entrepreneurial success, challenges, and community engagement. You'll get insights and advice from businesses focused on community here in Arizona. Today, we'll get an inside look at Capital Pump and Equipment, a local small business that sells, rents, and services large industrial water pumps for a variety of industries. Arizona Business Today, a National Bank of Arizona production.
That's another area, autonomous vehicles.
Yeah.
We've seen a lot of autonomous stuff in the mining industry.
Are you guys ready?
Good, yeah.
All right.
No worries.
Tom, thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me. Really appreciate being here.
Yeah, it's going to be a good conversation, and I'm really looking forward to hearing about Capital Pump and Equipment. Let's start with just tell us a little bit about what Capital Pump and Equipment does. I know you have a wide range of industries you serve.
We do. Capital Pump and Equipment, we're a full-service pump distributorship and rental company. So we have two distinct divisions, all related around pumping equipment, accessories for pumps. One division is a, like I said, full-service pump distributorship. We sell, distribute products for a variety of pump manufacturers. We have a field service division that goes and installs those pumps. We have a packaging division that'll package pumps into a turnkey system for customers. And we have a repair shop. The other side is a rental company where we'll rent them pumps and pumping equipment to keep people up and running in those times of need.
So what industries exactly do you work with?
The industries are mainly mining industry out here in Arizona, municipalities, cities, water treatment, wastewater treatment plants. We get into pharmaceuticals and semiconductor industry, manufacturing. It's really a broad spectrum.
Right.
Pumps are the second most common piece of rotating equipment and right behind electric motors. So there's a lot of uses for them.
Yeah. And we're not talking about little water pumps that you find on fountains here.
No, we do get into that. We have lines that sell that type of equipment, but it's not our everyday focus.
Yeah.
We're more industrial, large infrastructure type projects, things of that nature.
Large pumps.
Like large pumps.
Size of the corner of the room pumps.
Could get extremely large.
Yeah, that's great. Well, so how did you come to start Capital Pump and Equipment? I mean, what gave you the idea that this was a good opportunity?
Well, I'd always had an entrepreneurial spirit, always wanted to have my own thing or be a part of something where I had some ownership, and came back from college and was looking for a job. And I had some buddies over, and one of them said, hey, my dad has a pump manufacturing company. This was out of Oregon, and said, why don't you apply there? And so fell into it, started out as inside sales for a company called Pioneer Pump out of Oregon. Kind of climbed the ladder there, became an outside sales guy, handled the Western US, set up distribution, and I found it increasingly difficult to find
knowledgeable distributors that could apply the products properly. And so I thought, hey, this is my opportunity. I'm going to start my own distributorship. And that's kind of how it started.
So everybody has sort of a unique niche that they kind of go after to keep customers attracted to themselves. Mm-hmm. And so it's somewhat of an intentional strategy. How would you describe that at Capital Pump and Equipment?
Yeah, I would say that knowledge is power. And that's where we really focus. The pump industry scares a lot of people, I'd say. Pumps are very commonly used, but they are very finicky. If you don't know what you're doing or don't know how to size them properly, there's 1,000 different types of pumps. And within those types, there's a lot of different sizes, and it's easy to misapply a product. So we've really strategized on being experts in the pump industry and providing the customer with a fix to their problem, not just putting a Band-Aid on it or swapping out a pump that failed for the same size pump that failed. We like to do the homework and figure out, okay, why did this pump fail? Because most of the manufacturers these days have good quality products. Sure. It's just a matter of figuring out, okay, was it misapplied from the get-go? And we don't want to replace bad with bad. We want to solve the problem once and for all. And that's what we really focus on.
So you do service, though, as well.
Yes.
And that's an offshoot of your rental business.
Yeah. So it's all pump related, and it all intermingles and interwines. There's a lot of synergies in the different divisions that we have. Mm-hmm. The pump, when you sell a pump, all of a sudden you get asked by all the customers, well, hey, I've got one broken down. Can you repair my
sure.
pump? I may not want to buy a brand new one. So that leads you to having a repair shop. And then it's, hey, we want to buy that new pump from you, or hey, you repaired our pump, but can you go reinstall it in the field for us, or laser align our pump in the field for us? And that's how the field service division yep. came about for us. So everything just is, we're very customer oriented and customer focused. And when a customer brings something to us that it makes sense for us to add to our service offering, we jump at the chance to do it.
Yeah, and so then as you think about where do you want to be in the future, mm-hmm. is that the same path that you're gonna continue upon?
Yeah, I would say, I mean, the scalable side of our business and where we really wanna grow is the rental side of our business. It is a more profitable side, but it is highly capital intensive. And that was some of the struggles that we did face when we first got into business. We always had the intention of being a pump rental company, but in order to get there, I had to take a little bit of a different path. I had to, since we didn't have large financial backing, I basically started a pump distributorship, would buy and sell different product, and I would take those profit margins and slowly reinvest them into buying highly capital intensive rental equipment.
Right. With your own money.
With our own
money. That's not real.
We would self-fund. It wasn't easy. It was a long,
yeah.
long road. It took a handful of years,
sure.
you know, and from just getting one unit to, okay, now, hey, we've got 5, now we've got 10, now we've got 20. And then slowly getting that data we needed to go to a banking partner and say, hey, we're really onto something here. We do know what we're doing.
There is a demand. We do know
yeah.
how to do this.
So,
yeah.
And then getting an actual loan to, and then
yeah.
we were able to grow at a much faster rate.
Because
it is, you know, these pump packages do cost anywhere from, you know, $30,000 up to $100,000+ a piece. Mm-hmm. And now we're up to the size where we have 300 plus of those, and mm-hmm. we rent them on a regular basis. But yeah, it wasn't an easy road, and it wasn't just a snap of the fingers. It was a lot of long, hard
yeah.
work,
yeah.
long nights, a lot of weekends, and just persevering through any obstacles and challenges that came our way, and not taking no for an answer or not quitting. You know, that was
right. No, that's terrific.
Yeah, I started Capital Pump in 2013. Pumps are, I don't think anybody wakes up and says, oh, I'm gonna be in the pump industry, you know, when I get older, but it's just something that kind of finds you. I have a pretty analytical mind. You know, I always enjoyed math and things like that in school growing up, so it's kind of the perfect combination of physics and math and solving problems, and that's what I really enjoy is, you know, when a customer comes to you and maybe other companies have tried to throw equipment or money at a problem and they still have the same problem, I enjoy going out and actually solving the issue. And that's what we try to strive for at Capital Pump. And we've now got 100 employees that have the same mindset, and we're problem solvers. When you ask me what I do every day, that's really hard to answer because I do a variety of stuff. I go, you know, one minute it might be accounting stuff. The next minute it might be trying to put out a fire, maybe an issue that's arisen, and it has to climb to a certain degree now for people to feel like I need to know about it, which is probably the toughest part of a growing business. Not maybe knowing everything that's happening until sometimes it's too late. But a typical day for me is anything from dealing with accounting situations to personnel issues to helping on the shop floor, possibly troubleshoot a pump issue, helping our rental division size pumps and make sure we're selecting the correct pump the first time and putting the right equipment out on the job to get the job done. We've continued to grow since day one. It started out with me and my condo, just selling whatever I could sell and not taking no for an answer and just kind of being persistent and trying to get those first clients. And from there, we were able to go out and get some highly talented employees. And we've grown it from there year after year. In 2013, it was one person, and now we're up to 100 people in 2021. As we've added people and personnel, we've needed more space. So the original condo that we were in wasn't gonna cut it. So we moved from a condo early on into a little business park where we rented a small space and outgrew that quickly. And we moved into a place for 5 years in Tempe that suited our needs for a while, but we soon outgrew that as well. And then that's when we approached National Bank about building this facility, and they gave us the green light. So we build our headquarters here, which is about 34,000 square feet.
Yeah.
I have the window out here just so I can, look out and see kind of what's going on. If we hear a loud noise or anything in the shop, make sure everybody's all right and then, somebody didn't drop anything or is hurt out there. That's one of the main reasons, but also just I enjoy, seeing the production happen, I guess. It's, every now and then you need to take a little break and look out and see what we're actually making and the problems we're solving for our customers. Sometimes it does get loud. I would say that's one of the things we probably could have thought through a little better is maybe insulating these walls a little bit better. I think it's just part of the industry we're in. We all signed up for it, so it's going to get loud and noisy from time to time. We have all of our back office here. We have our outside sales, inside sales force out of this Phoenix market out of here as well. We have a shop where we repair our own rental equipment and customers' pumps of all different sorts and kinds and types. We have a fabrication wing where we actually fabricate and weld trailer packages, skids, bases to make some of our own kind of turnkey pump packages for the customers. And we have a machine shop out there. And then outside is a lot of our storage for our rental fleet and rental accessories, pipe and fittings and everything that it takes to make a turnkey dewatering or bypass system. Even though we've got this awesome building with all these bells and whistles, none of it would be possible without our great employees. Our employees have allowed us to get to this level where we could go out and build this building. One of my goals when I started the business was to be a great employer. We wanted to offer great benefits to our employees, great health insurance benefits. I know that's a huge cost. The company does shoulder a big burden on that, but I think it's very important to recruit great talent and to retain great talent, because without them it's not possible.
Well, so how's the business doing right now?
It's good. We're growing. We've been growing ever since 2013 when we started. We're up to about 100 employees now.
Wow.
And we're continuing
all
to look
here in the state?
All here locally, and we also have some employees in Oregon currently.
Oh, good.
But we are looking to expand and branch out, and we have some target metropolitan areas, I guess, in other states that we're actively vetting to see if that would be a good place for us to open a branch or not.
And this growth, I know, has made you kind of start to look around for new space. Mm-hmm. And I know that we were fortunately able to help you with a new building. And I think Tom Coppy in our Mesa office was the banker that worked with you on that. How did that all go? And how did you find us? Or how did we find you? And how did that all come together?
Yeah. The building went great. And Tom Coppy has been a phenomenal advocate for us. And that's what I would say about
National Bank of Arizona. You guys are, you know, a larger bank. You have the funding to give us the and get us into the loans that we need. However, you have that small bank feel.
Hey, Tom and Carmel, how's it going? Hey, good to see you. Yeah, good to see you. Hey, how are you? Good to see you. No, no. Can we do that? No, here, come on.
Just like we did up there.
Yeah, just like
we did.
Yeah, that'll be tough for him to. Yeah, come on up. Let's go upstairs.
All sorts of irons in the fire.
Yeah, there always is for you guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, how are you guys doing?
Doing great.
Wonderful. Yeah.
Just keeping busy and.
So how's business going? You know, what's the latest? Things are always moving fast for you, so we can use this time to catch up anyway.
Yeah. So these are my two bankers from National Bank of Arizona. We have Carmel, and she's my personal banker, and we have Tom, and he's our business banker.
Tom and his group approached us at one point about several years ago. And I knew as I was explaining the business to them that they got it. They actually understood it. So it's been awesome working with Tom.
It's just been a real pleasure to work with him, and his business is growing fast. There's so much opportunity for him. It's been really exciting to be just a small part of his growth story. So we just really enjoy working with Capital Pump and Equipment. Like most of our businesses, they're privately owned, and so we have an ownership team that they have their own personal banking needs as well. And so we introduced Carmel, and then she's able to take over the personal side and deliver that level of expertise on Tom's personal banking needs.
Breakfast is where
we met. Yeah. And then Tom's invited me to come over to it, actually the old building, popped in a couple of times. And
Carmel and Tom, they talk to each other, they work together behind the scenes. From a standpoint of on the personal side, if I did want a loan or something personally for something, just with the financials and the way small business owners maybe pay themselves or all of that stuff, they understand the ins and outs of that and work together so we can get those loans on a personal side or a business side.
Just meeting Tom at breakfast for the first time and listening to his story and telling me, you know, how he started the company from ground zero, it was really energizing for me. I love working with people like Tom. I love working with Tom. He's fun, he's energetic, he loves what he does. It's really a nice relationship that we're able to offer things that are very beneficial to Tom and work hand in hand with our commercial partners.
When we partner internally, we have clients that are customers of the commercial side, they're also customers of the private banking side. And we really hope and believe that it brings value to them. And we communicate with each other. We don't operate in silos where the other person doesn't know what's happening. So we talk with one another, we collaborate with one another to serve our clients' needs. And we believe it really brings them value and brings them a more cohesive relationship.
I 100% agree. It's a really great way to do business, and I think it's just an easier way for the client.
All right, so this is our upstairs conference room. And then we also have this big bullpen area where a lot of our outside salespeople, they can come in and pick a cubicle and get some emails done and things like that, and a little collaboration area. Now that you've seen upstairs, let's head on downstairs. If you guys have any questions, fire away. These are different offices. We wanted to create a team atmosphere here, so a lot of our, we have these workstations internally for a lot of our back office staff. Easy access, everybody can collaborate and work as a team and kind of build that bond.
What's the current total FTE? It's all employees?
100.
100?
Wow. Yeah. This is where, you know, everybody eats lunch.
Yeah. And my favorite
thing with the whole place was that. I don't know how they had it, they got it so quiet. I wish my garage doors at the house were like.
Capital Pump and Coffee. Yep.
This is our kind of shop warehouse area. We're actually going to be putting a paint booth in here. We have this temporary one right now, but we'll talk about how much that'll cost.
We'll need to finance that.
Yeah, exactly. This is our machine shop area. So we have a metal saw, vertical mill, a dynamic balancer, two 10-ton cranes, as you guys can see, that span the whole length of the building. That was a feature that you guys helped us finance and put in. And now we can go outside. This is just different. These are large. These are 12-inch pump packages. These are used a lot on sewer bypass projects.
So. Tom, how big is the footprint here?
It's 5 acres. Yeah, 5 acres, and The building, I think, came in at right around 34,000 square feet or so, maybe 30.
Yeah, now that we're here in the new building, isn't it fantastic? This place is a wonderful building. We were so excited to be able to help Tom finance this building. He picked a great contractor. We have a great construction financing team, and the construction process went very smooth. And now we're here and the business is running and gunning and it's wonderful.
Yeah, I feel like we're getting settled in. Yeah, for sure.
So Tom, as I think a little bit about Capital Pump and Equipment and how you got started, tell me about some of the biggest hurdles you faced or the greatest challenges. And as our viewers are listening in, you know, what should they maybe take away from how you get started in a company?
So I would say two things. One, persevere. Just keep going forward. No matter how bad it looks, keep trudging ahead and eventually you'll get there and get to a better place. And two, never stop learning. I'm in an industry where it's changing constantly. There's a lot of, a lot of technology coming about that we're constantly learning how to adapt new technologies to the pumping industry, to monitoring stuff remotely, to turning pumps on remotely, to taking human error out of the equation.
So we had chatted earlier a little bit. As you start looking at technology, which is obviously a big part of your business, robotics, artificial intelligence is starting to really take hold. I mean, it's really very progressive now. In many, many industries, many of the ones you're dealing with in particular. How do you see that affecting the pump industry or even possibly the price points that they may be able to pay?
Yeah, we do see a lot of it. We see technology influencing the products we sell on a regular basis. It is increasing the cost here out of the gate of the capital expenditure for the equipment for the customers. But in the long run, the cost of ownership is going down because they're able to remotely monitor that pump station where maybe before they had to have somebody run out there each and every time there was an alarm and see what was going on. It's technology is improving quickly in the pump industry, and it's providing a major learning curve for all the pump distributors, and there's a lot more regulation too. We deal with the EPA, we deal with a lot of diesel engines.
Well, we've got these historically low interest rates. Mm-hmm. I don't think anyone really expects that to be the foreseeable future for us. Mm-hmm. We have a very large national debt crisis, I would almost call it today. How do you see that playing into Capital Pump and Equipment's long-term strategy?
Yeah, it's definitely something that we think about and we're concerned about. I mean, right now, very capital-intensive business, our rental side especially. So interest rates, being able to get equipment loans at low rates is very nice. So we're trying to gobble up as much fleet and stuff as we can right now. But we know that those times may not last forever. So we really are trying to be extremely strategic, grow in during this period if we can, and be ready to weather the next storms that come our way.
Yeah,
and good. Have the equipment to do so.
When's that going to happen? When's the next storm?
I don't know, probably tomorrow.
Yeah, that's my baby. Yeah. Well, Tom, thanks for joining us today. It's been a real pleasure.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I'm really curious about your oil and gas division.
Right.
A little bit more.
Yeah, it's going to be a great effort.
That's great. Thank you, Tom. That was really good.
You did a great job. You seem like a polished guy.
Yeah.
That's not your first rodeo, huh?
Well,